When you first go to redcap.pcom.edu, your landing page is the RedCap homepage. Here, you can see a link to our RedCap LibGuide, which has lots of information about RedCap account, RedCap policies and procedures, and all the tutorial videos. Once you log in, you'll go to the My Projects page. This is a list of all the projects that you have access to. It provides basic information about each project, such as the number of records and fields, type of project, and whether it's in production or development mode. You can organize your projects into folders by using the Organize button. Here, you can enter a folder name and pick different colors to change how the folder name displays on your list. Then you can select it on the drop-down on the right and say what projects you want to put in the folder. Once you click Close, everything will be in folders, and you could choose to limit or expand how many projects you're seeing at any given time. The Help and FAQ tab links to the general RedCap FAQ. You can use Control F to search for specific topics or find topics on the drop-down menu. The FAQ is maintained by a RedCap Consortium committee and is kept up to date. It's a great reference for a lot of basic questions. It's especially useful for things like calculations, branching logic, or piping where you might have to use a specific syntax, such as the date diff calculation. On the Training Videos tab, Vanderbilt University provides videos. These videos explain how to use RedCap, but we do recommend that you use our videos as a general rule, because our videos go over PCOM-specific policies and procedures. On the New Project tab, you can create a new project. You'll need to give it a title, a purpose, and specify a type of research when doing a research project. You can choose to assign the project to a specific folder. Project notes are used to describe the purpose of the project and are only for your reference. If it's your only RedCap project, you might not need to put anything in the notes. But if you're making a major change to a project and you're testing a copy, use project notes. The notes are useful for keeping track of your processes and procedures throughout the different stages of your project. Finally, you have the option to begin the project from scratch, upload a previous RedCap project, or use a template. Creating an empty project is self-explanatory. To move a project from another university's RedCap to PCOM's RedCap, download the project as an XML file, and then upload using the Upload RedCap Project XML File option. This copies the data dictionary, the data, and project setup metadata. You also have the option of using a template. Feel free to play around with using templates when creating a new RedCap project. It's a great way to learn a little bit more about the system. Once you've made your choices, hit Create Project, and it will take you to the Project Setup page, where you can start building your new project.